कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी सोलापुर। टुडे विल गो फॉर इनफिक्स नोटेशन फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट डिस्क्रीट मैथमेटिकल स्ट्रक्चर्स। विल ऑल्सो सी हाउ टू कन्वर्ट इनफिक्स नोटेशन इंटू कंप्लीटली पैरेंथेसाइज्ड फॉर्म एंड प्रीफिक्स नोटेशन। The learning outcome of today's sessions, student will be able to express precedence of operator, then he will be able to convert the infix notation into fully parenthesized infix notation. The content of the today's videos are, first of all we'll see what is the priority of or the precedence of operator, then how infix notations or expressions are evaluated, then how to convert the given infix expression into fully parenthesized form. Then we'll also see what are the different rules for evaluating prefix expression or notation. Following is the precedence of operator. Now we have different operators like and, or, conditional, biconditional, NAND, NOR and so on. Let us see the precedence of operator. Now if you look at this operator, first of all negation, then conjunction, disjunction, conditional, biconditional. Conditional and or negation and or conditional, biconditional. Now the priority is that first of all the negation will be evaluated first, then conditional, biconditional, then and, or conditional and biconditional. This is the precedence. Negation has got the highest precedence, followed by and, or conditional and biconditional. If statement formula has parenthesis, then the innermost parenthesis will be evaluated first, followed by the outer and the outermost parenthesis. Inside parenthesis, statement formula will have the same precedence as I told earlier, that is negation and or conditional and biconditional. Now let us consider one example. This is example P or Q and R or S and T. Here we see that there are two operators they are used, that is one is OR, second one is AND, OR and means two operators OR and are used. How the evaluation will take place? What is the precedence of operator? Now negation is not there, so after that condition AND will be evaluated. So first of all Q and R will be evaluated, then S and T will be evaluated, that is step number 2. After that this OR will be evaluated, P OR, this expression result of Q and R will be evaluated. Finally the result of P OR Q and R and the result of S and T, they are in a disjunction, that will be evaluated at the step number 4. In the above expression has highest precedence and 4 has a 1 has the highest precedence and 4 has the least precedence. The expression will be evaluated according to the precedence of operator. Now let us see the conversion of infix notation into fully parenthesized form. Now P or Q and R or S and T. Let us now if I write in this way and if I put the brackets, so that will be if I put the brackets, what will happen? I will come to know that the innermost bracket will be evaluated first, then the outer and the outermost bracket will be evaluated. So for a human being it will be easier to understand which operator will be evaluated first. So let us see just how to convert infix to fully parenthesized one. Now in this expression, as this AND, that is Q and R, will be evaluated first, then S and T will be evaluated second, then P or this result of Q and R. So the highest precedent Q and R. So we, let us write a bracket like Q and R. Then say in second step, S and T will be evaluated. So put a bracket for S and T. Then finally, the in the third step, P or the result of Q or R will be placed one more bracket over here there. That is innermost bracket P or into bracket Q and R. And in the finally, S and T will be disjuncted with this result of the third step. That is, so finally the formula will look like a innermost bracket P or Q and R bracket close or S and T. So is the final parenthesis expression after fourth precedence. Now consider this example or expression and convert it into fully precedence expression according to operator precedence, fully parenthesized form rather. P conditional Q or R or S, take a pause for a minute and try to write down the answer. The solution, the parenthesis according to the precedence is first of all Q or R, one bracket, then Q or R with or with S, one more bracket, and finally one more bracket including P with a conditional operator. So this is the solution. This is called as a fully parenthesized form for the expression which has no brackets, that is infix expression. Now the rules for evaluating prefix expression. The first rule says that, now if I give the expression, consider this expression P conditional Q or R or S. This is an infix expression. Now prefix expression will be or AB, or A or B is the infix expression, and prefix will be, as we know that prefix will be first of all operator followed by the two operands. So first of all operators will be scanned followed by the operands prefix. So the rules for evaluating prefix expression, find the rightmost operator in the expression, then they select the two operands immediately to the right of the operator found, perform the indicated operation and replace the operator and operands with the result. If I write an expression over here, let us consider this expression A or B or C. This is the expression. Let us convert this into prefix expression. Now first of all, the priority for A or B will be evaluated first. In the second step, the result of A or B will be connected with C. So first of all, convert A or B into prefix. So A or B will be converted into A or B is equal to first of all operator followed by the two operands. Since it is a binary operator, we write two operands. So let us give some name, say as a result T1. So this is step number 2. Now substitute this T1 in the equation number given 1. So this equation number 1 will become now T1 or C. So let us convert this T1 or C into prefix. So that will be or T1C. So this is step number 3. Now substitute T1 in the expression, in the equation number 3, the T1 is nothing but or AB. So this or, then or ABC. So this is a final prefix expression. So this is a final prefix expression. So if you look at, so this is a conversion of infix to prefix. Now the reference is the discrete mathematical structure book is used. I hope you understood how to convert infix to completely parenthesized form and infix to prefix form. Thank you.